When Shaniya-Davis disappeared 8 days ago, her mother, 25-year-old Antoinette-Davis, dialed 911.
Yes,
ma'am. Okay, ma'am. How can I help you?
I woke up this morning and my daughter was not in the house. I don't know if she walked out. I don't know what's going on, but she's not here.
How old is your daughter?
She's five.
Five?
Human trafficking, ma'am, is a Class C felony.
Police now believe Shania's mother was lying, that the call was part of a cover-up, that Antoinette-Davis knew just hours earlier she had sold her daughter as a sex slave.
And your door was not unlocked, that's what you're telling me?
No, it was not unlocked, but I'm telling you she knows how to unlock it. I'm hoping that she didn't unlock it and walk out.
Police have charged 29-year-old Mario McNeil with kidnapping. On the morning Shania disappeared, detectives say McNeil was spotted on a hotel surveillance camera, holding the 5-year-old in his arms. Investigators say they believe when Shania left the hotel, she was still alive. Her body was found Monday in the woods, 7 miles from that hotel. In this community, there are now equal parts shock and anger.
I have children. I have babies. You know, it would devastate me alone to know that it wouldn't happen to my children.
Shania's body was positively identified by the medical examiner on Tuesday.
It's not the result I wanted. It's not the result any father or family would want for their children. But God has a greater calling for all of us.
The 5-year-old had lived most of her life with her father, Brad Lockhart. He had raised her and says allowing Shania's mother to have informal temporary custody beginning in mid-October was based on his belief Shania should better know her birth mother.
Sorry, baby, that you have to do this, but you're in a better place. You're in better hands. You don't have to hurt no more.
Brad's sister, Carrie, who raised Shania as if she were her own, last saw her niece when she dropped Shania off at her mother's house last month.
I went and took her to visit her mother. I packed her with 2 days' worth of clothes. I got her out of the car and I kissed her goodbye and I told her to be a good girl. She turned back to me and said, I love you, Aunt Carrie, and see you later.